Now, September 1967, a naval combat veteran by the name of Jack Pickett, who I was really good friends with, he's no longer with us, he claims that during September 1967, he was a publisher of the NCO Club newspaper, and they were going down a perimeter road at MacDill Air Force Base, which is in Tampa, and they got to this area right here, which is called the base scrapyard. And when he got there, he looked over the chain link fence and saw four of the most incredible aircraft that he had ever seen in his entire life. Just an incredible configuration. They measured 20, 40, 70. The largest one was 116 feet in diameter. They all had the same configuration, but different sizes. They had tricycle landing gear. There was an air intake on both sides of the pilot's compartment. And then this very huge vertical tail that tapered back to the pilot's compartment had control surfaces along the circumference of the disc. So this is September 1967. This is the long-range bomber version of this aircraft. According to Jack, he was told that this was used as a long-range reconnaissance bomber during the Cold War. And so he asked a lot of questions from the general who was over at MacDill Air Force Base and inquired about putting together an article for the base publication newsletter. He was given authorization to write that article, which was titled Flying Saucers for Real, and then he was given 16 officially stamped black and white glossy photographs of these aircraft parked on the tarmac, in flight, also with F-86 jet fighter interceptors, F-84 jet fighter interceptors as well, and had a tremendous amount of information regarding this program all ready to go into this article. But then it turns out, just before going to press with this particular article, there was an overflight of a VTOL, vertical takeoff and landing version of this aircraft, which rolls down the runway. This is a horizontal takeoff bird. That particular aircraft suffered a propulsion system malfunction, dropped down to treetop level, flew directly over Miami at high speed and woke everyone up. The next morning, it was all over the newspapers, all over the news. And so he brought that newspaper into the general's office the next morning and said, "General, I think we've got a problem here, because I'm getting ready to declassify and release this jet-powered disc that you have at the scrapyard, but then you're denying the existence of this aircraft that flew over downtown Miami. What do you guys want to do about it?" So that general contacted Offutt Air Force Base, contacted the Secretary of Defense and the Secretary of the Air Force, and according to the Secretary of the Air Force, it would be in the better interest of the Air Force to delay publication, and that's where this story died back in 1967. So we were within hours of getting the truth about one of our classified programs brought into the public domain, within hours, but then it was canceled.